Rataya, Rakalaboko Zitiri Handali Bragosu Kandalaya, Alali Baguli Bragosa Taragalataya. Oh, blessed be God forever. Blessed be God forever. Oh, Rikalantaragali Bragosa. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Uri galabosi chiri galata ya. Ura galata la galabosi chiri galata ya. Raka galata la galaboko sotiri galata ya. Rika galata la galaboko sotiri galata ya. Raka galaboko sotiri galata ya. Ika galata la galaboko sotiri galata ya. Blessed be God. Blessed be God. Father, you are worthy. Father, you are worthy. Thank you, Lord. In moments like these, I sing out a song. I sing out a love song to Jesus. In moments like these, I lift up my hands. I lift up.
You are the only living God. Yes, you are.
You are the only.
Heaven-bound family.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty has brought you again.
Amen.
It is by His mercy.
Amen.
To God be all the glory.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you for coming. My mother, our daddies, our brothers and sisters, thank you for coming.
Amen.
Thank you for all the sharing you have been doing as well. Please go on and keep on sharing. People are giving testimonies because of your share. Somebody told me that day, I don't know who shared, but I just saw it.
Hallelujah.
And I was blessed.
Amen.
Whoever that person that shared, that blessed that soul, the Lord God Almighty will give you a double reward.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
By the grace of God today, the Lord has gathered us again.
Amen.
It's a day that the Lord indeed has made.
Hallelujah.
And we shall rejoice and be glad
Amen.
In it.
Amen.
By the mercy of God.
Amen.
So how is the race?
Running.
We are not checking month.
No.
Our race has no January, has no March.
Da.
We keep on pressing on.
Yes,
we keep
Lord.
On running
yes,
to meet our Redeemer.
Amen.
For He said, nobody knows the day nor the hour.
Yes.
So we are not walking by dates. God Almighty will preserve us
Amen.
To the finishing line.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And how is your family?
I am planted
in holiness. With who? With God and God alone. God and God alone, God and God alone, that is my watchword. God and God alone, God and God alone, that is my watchword. Planted in holiness, sowing in holiness. His name is the ancient of days.
Hallelujah.
He has stopped growing. God is established as one God.
Yes, sir.
So go to the book of Hosea, chapter 13, verse 4. God Almighty is one. Chapter 13, verse number 4.
Hosea 13, verse 4.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I am the Lord thy God from the land of Egypt.
The Lord is announcing himself.
Yeah.
He said he is the Lord our God.
Yes, yeah. From the land of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt know no God but me.
You must not look for another God.
Uh-huh.
No human being is qualified to be your God.
Yes, right.
You will not know any other God except God.
That's right. For there is no Savior beside me.
Hallelujah. God said his name is Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
There is no Savior beside him. He is the Savior.
Yes, Lord.
He entered into man. God Almighty is going to teach us more about himself.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because this is a season for feet dwellers.
Hallelujah.
Who are feet dwellers? Feet dwellers are those that sit at the feet of Jesus.
Amen.
To receive teachings.
Amen.
To learn of the Lord.
Amen.
Because the Lord said in this month of July, he wants to teach us.
Amen.
He said, come unto me and learn of me. That's what Matthew chapter 11 verse 29 says. He said, come and learn. Matthew 11 29.
Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 11 and verse 39.
What does he say?
Take my yoke upon you and learn of me.
The Lord said, take my yoke. That means make our time.
Yes.
Make me priority. That's what the Lord is saying. It may look like a yoke because you have other things that are dragging for that same attention.
Yes,
but Lord said, take my own yoke
upon you.
Take it upon you.
That's right.
Take responsibility for your soul.
That's
and come and do what?
And learn of me.
Come and learn of me. God, the Lord said, I want to teach you. Child of God, without teaching, we cannot pray the will of God. But when we begin to sit at his feet, those are the feet dwellers. Are you a feet dweller? I am a feet dweller. I am sitting at the feet of Rabboni to learn of him. And what is the result?
For I am meek and lowly in heart.
The Lord said, there's a character I want to develop in you. It is called meekness. It is called a heart that is lonely, just like him. Not a puffed up heart. Not a proud heart. Not a heart. Because today God is going to deal with pride. There is a spirit in us that God Almighty wants to remove and put his spirit.
Amen.
The spirit of meekness.
Amen.
Until God achieves it, child of God, we're not going anywhere. Heaven is not going to accept us. Because heaven will accept its kind.
Yes.
And the people that go to heaven are meek people.
Yes.
People that their flesh has left earth. Before heaven can kiss you. Child of God, God Almighty is going on to the practical life of a Christian.
Amen.
Not a title. Not a religious thing of I am a Christian. There's a lifestyle that follows the life of a Christian. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A few announcements we have is number one on the list is water baptism.
Amen.
Child of God, it is the will of God.
Yes.
God wants us to be baptized. Go to the book of Mark chapter 16. 15 to 18. Mark 16, 15 to 18. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Mark chapter 16.
Yes.
I read from verse 15 to 18.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
And he said unto them,
yes,
go ye into all the world
and
preach the gospel to
yes.
every creature.
All of us must hear gospel.
That's right. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
So the Lord said, he that believeth, he put addendum, and be baptized shall be saved.
That's right.
That means baptism is part and parcel of our salvation.
Yes.
But
he that believeth not shall be then.
The Lord said, when you do not believe, you will not even go for baptism. There's no addendum. Because you don't believe. So automatically there is damnation. There's destruction.
And this sign shall follow them that believe.
The Lord said, once we have baptized, we have accepted, we are saved, automatically we are called believers.
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ came for believers.
Yeah.
He didn't come for Christianity. He came for believers. He said, there are signs that we follow believers for people to know that you are a believer. Number one,
in my name shall they cast out devils.
In my name.
In my name.
In the name of God, the Father, God, the Son, God, the Holy Ghost.
In my name.
That is a name that demons respect. It is the name Jesus Christ. He said, in my name
shall they cast out devils.
No, they will give that microphone to interview them.
Shall they cast out?
Preachers are giving microphone to people for demons to speak to them. The Bible says they should be cast out, not interviewed. Now ask where they're coming from, where they're going to. God didn't call us into that ministry. He said, cast them out.
They shall speak with new tongues.
The Lord said he's going to give us the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Sign of God, if you don't have the Holy Ghost, there is no sign that you're a believer.
Hallelujah.
You don't rest. Don't relax until this sign manifests in your lives.
Yes.
Which is the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
With evidence of speaking in new tongues.
Verse 18, they shall take up serpents.
The Bible says you are not going to be afraid. Mm. You can take up serpents.
That's right.
You can take up scorpions.
Yes.
And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them.
The Lord said, drink deadly things in his name. Remember, his name is there.
Yes.
You are going for evangelism and somebody offers. The Lord said, take it in my name.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing will happen to you.
That's right.
You shall take deadly things.
And it shall not hurt them.
It will not hurt you.
That's right.
As he finished.
They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
The Lord said there is no special prophet. There's no healing preacher.
No.
He's a believer.
Yes.
Can lay hands
on the sick.
On the sick.
And they shall recover.
But these days you can see now that they have given us a law that we cannot talk to people. Yes. So they have removed the Great Commission. People are preachers are now using hand sanitizer. Before they can lay hands, they use gloves. They say we are by faith receive your healing.
Yes.
In fact, a preacher told me that because of the situation, he cannot even give me a handshake. He cannot shake my hand. He has to observe protocol. God is going to deliver us from wickedness.
Amen.
The Lord said, they shall lay hands
on the sick.
On the sick.
And they shall recover.
And the sick shall recover.
Amen.
God Almighty is calling you and I to be a believer. Say, I am a believer.
I am a believer.
See, we are learning already.
Yes.
We are fifth dwellers.
Hallelujah.
You have been reading this scripture,
yes,
but you have learned something new.
Yes, Lord.
And we'll learn more.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So child of God, go for baptism. In the name of Jesus Christ, go into the water and let them baptize you properly. If they didn't mention the name Jesus Christ, you are not put on Christ. It is a prerequisite, and we'll keep on saying it until people are delivered.
Amen.
From the spirit of religion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Second announcement is that by the grace of God, from next week, we are going to change the name of our page. So we are going to give us the new name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going to give us a new name for the page. We are not going to be answering in Kechi Jehovah anymore. From next week, Daddy God wants to give us a new name.
Hallelujah.
So watch out for that name. And the name of the Lord will be glorified on that page.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
By the grace of God, today we have a message sung. The song says, oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder, then sings my soul. Child of God, our soul should sing before our lips. Many people are singing with their lips and their soul is far away. Their soul is wandering around the world, thinking about so many things. They are buying and selling. God Almighty said, your soul must sing first. We saw it in Psalm 103.
Yes.
He said, bless the Lord, oh my soul. When our soul begins to bless God, God Almighty doesn't care about voice. He doesn't care. That the deaf and dumb are considered here by God, because people have used good voice to cover up for worship. God said, I look at the soul. This is what the soul is saying that I take.
Yes.
More than the lips. The Lord God Almighty will teach us how to worship him.
Amen.
In spirit and in truth.
Amen.
With our soul.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So as we begin this month, we are worshiping God.
Amen.
By telling him that he is great.
Amen.
And he will remain great.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Amen. Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider the works thy hand has made. Oh, Thank you, Father, Lord God Almighty.
Thank you, Lord.
We are grateful.
Hallelujah.
Thank you that we can worship you.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for putting song in our mouth to
sing.
Many have stopped singing.
Yes.
Birds are even tired of singing. All we hear is noise of pain and sorrow. All we hear is noise of the world. Father, Lord, we give you praise. The Lord, we can give you praise. We can sing, oh Lord. It is a miracle, Lord. Glory be to the Holy. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for gathering us again.
Thank you, Lord.
In this month of July, you are the only one that knows everything about this month.
Yes,
because you're already at the end waiting for us. And that is our consolation, Lord. You're in control of our lives. Thank you, precious Redeemer.
Thank you, Lord.
That we lay our lives on the altar.
Yes, Lord.
Set our hearts that examine us, Lord. Everything that doesn't glorify you in us, we ask for your mercy.
Amen.
We repent before you, Lord.
Yes,
have mercy on us. Cleanse us from every stain of sin.
Amen.
Every wickedness of the heart.
Amen.
Every hypocrisy.
Amen.
Whatever you do not like in us, Father, please root it out of our lives.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for your son there, your daughter
thank
over
you,
there.
Dad.
Look at that family over there.
Thank
look
you,
at that
son.
Teenager. Look at that elder
Lord,
there. Yes, the Lord God Almighty will touch everyone.
Amen.
At the very point of their need.
Amen.
Let nobody live here the same.
Amen.
Let everyone, O Lord, receive from you, Lord.
Amen.
And open the eyes of our understanding.
Amen.
To understand the scriptures.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Thank you, Lord, even for the global altar crew
thank
here.
You, Lord.
Yes, the Lord God Almighty will lay your hands on all of us.
Amen.
Nobody, Lord, speak of themselves or sing of themselves or pray of themselves. Let everything, oh God, be led by your spirit.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Daddy God.
Thank you, Lord.
Wrap yourself
Jesus.
Around me
Amen.
And just take your praise.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are the teacher.
Yes,
you are our rabboni. Glorify your name, Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, sweet dad.
Thank you, Lord.
The network is in your hand.
Yes,
all the airwaves in your hand.
Yes,
all about the world, oh Lord, take control.
Amen.
And let us have a connection with you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The rapture will take place while we are here. Father, let all of us be caught up to be with you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Thank you, Dad.
Thank
we
you,
love you. We love you. We love you.
Love
there's no one like you. Glory be to you.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus Christ, unchallengeable mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
Child of God Almighty is calling us today to begin to sit at his feet.
Amen.
And when you look upon him, there's something that comes in.
Amen.
To you, there's power in the eye.
Yes.
Some go to the book of Matthew, chapter 6. 22-23. The place of learning is at the feet so that we can look up to him.
Amen.
Matthew 6:22-23.
The light of the body is the eye.
Yes.
If therefore thine eye be single,
uh-huh.
thy whole body shall be full of light.
Yes.
But if thine eye be evil,
uh-huh.
thy whole body shall be full of darkness.
Yes.
If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness,
uh-huh.
how great is that darkness?
Child of God, the Lord God Almighty is calling us to look into his eyes. If your eye and my eyes are focused on the Lord, it is called singular eyes. When we begin to mix it with other things, darkness comes automatically. God doesn't follow things. God is God all by himself. He is seated on his throne. He doesn't follow things. They are created things. God Almighty said, when we look into his eyes, he's going to shine light through us and then everything about us will become light. You will not struggle with dressing. You will not struggle with relationships. Why? Your mind is filled with light. You don't have any evil thoughts in you. The reason why we are not living this life that the Lord wants us to live of everything about us being light is because we are mixing it with religion. We are mixing it with church activities. The Lord God Almighty said, the light of the body, because the body needs light.
Yes.
That is the only way we can present it to the Lord without arguments. The light of the body is the eye. Child of God, who are you looking at? Who is your focus? Or what is your focus? Because some people, their focus is money. That is why you can kneel down for people when they give you money. You kneel down and you will hold the money like this and you are worshipping money. Your eyes are on the giver of the money, the human giver, and the money. You never think of God. The next thing you think about is what you are going to do with that money. The Lord God Almighty is calling us to become singular this season.
Amen.
Remove your eye from every other thing or person that you have been putting attention on, so they can shine light into us.
Amen.
So our faith will not be undercover.
Amen.
Our faith will shine out. Continue, God is going to talk about shining.
Amen.
You know, this is a season of faith dwelling.
Amen.
To learn truths. So today the topic is learn the truth about stars. Learning the truth about stars. That is the topic for today. Learning the truth about stars. S-T-A-R-S. You know, when they say you're a star, remember the night I finished ministry, and then I went out, and then people, somebody was greeting me. And I said, I don't know you. The person said, don't you know that you're a star? Unconsciously, I began to feel special. Unconsciously, I began to think that I am too much. Yeah, Kalaboko something. Child of God, today we will know the truth about stars.
Amen.
Whether we are called stars in God's sight. Whether God wants us to be stars. God Almighty said today, He's going to open our eyes and we know what we have been thinking. We have been thinking that this is right. We will begin to know that it is not right. We are going to unlearn many things.
Amen.
This is my star will shine. These things are none of God. We will see scripture today.
Amen.
You can't say he's taking my star. They have exchanged my star. It's not scriptural. Because child of God, many of us have entered bondage with such worldly terminologies about stars. Let's begin to go into the scripture. Stars are created by God. They are creatures. And why did God create things? It's for us to worship Him, just like we have worshipped Him with, oh Lord my God. How great are I see the stars. I hear the roaring thunder. God Almighty said, the reason why I created things is not for you to worship them. For we cannot worship creature. Creature cannot worship creature. Creature worships creator.
Hallelujah.
If the stars even had their way, they would tell us to stop worshiping them.
Yes.
Because we are going to see the scripture that they themselves, they know that they are created. They worship God. We have to worship God in His greatness for what He has made. Genesis 1:16. Scriptures to write. Genesis 1:16, Psalm 8, verse 3. Today we are going to read nothing less than 40 scriptures.
Hallelujah.
Psalm 8, verse 3.
Yes, sir.
Job 9, 7. Job 22, 12. Jeremiah 31, 35. These are the scriptures for now, son.
Amen.
So let us begin to enjoy with the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Genesis 1:16.
Genesis chapter 1, I read verse 16.
Yes, sir.
And God made two great lights. The greater light to rule the day, the lesser light to rule the night.
Yes,
He made the stars. Also.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Child of God, these are creatures of God. So stars are creatures.
Yes.
Next scripture.
Psalm 8, verse 3.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
When I consider thy heavens,
hallelujah,
the work of thy fingers,
yes, sir,
the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained,
hallelujah.
Amen.
God Almighty said, learn today that stars are created.
Yes.
I created them. And there's a reason why I created them. Read on.
Yes.
Job chapter 9, verse 7.
Yes, sir. Then Job 22, 12. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Job chapter 9, I read verse 7.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Which commanded the sun,
And
it riseth not,
yes,
and sealeth up the stars.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Child of God, you can see God's hand.
Yes.
He's supervising His creature.
Yes.
Next verse. Job 22, 12.
Job chapter 22.
Yes.
Verse 12.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
It's not God in the height of heaven. And behold the height of the stars. How high they are.
Child of God, these are things that God is using to increase our worship altar.
Yes.
For many of us don't know how to worship God. God is giving us the things that should propel us to fear Him, to honor Him, to reference Him. That He is the one that made these things that make you to wonder and gaze. He made them.
Yes.
He's giving us the appetite.
Yes.
He's putting a hunger in us to praise Him. He's putting sweetness. He's giving us sugar so that we can worship Him. What is the Jeremiah verse? 31:35. Jeremiah 31:35.
Jeremiah 31, I read verse 35.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thus saith the Lord.
Yes, sir.
We give up the sun for a light by day.
Uh-huh.
And the ordinances of the moon.
Uh-huh.
And of the stars.
Uh-huh.
For a light by night.
Uh-huh.
Which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar.
Uh-huh.
The Lord of hosts is his
name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God Almighty said, worship the Lord of hosts.
Amen.
Not sun.
Uh-huh.
In Nigeria, they call it Shango or Ogun, all those things. Not all those things. God wants us to worship Him that made those things.
Yes, sir.
But the devil has usually used to pervert. We will learn today.
Amen.
I am at the feet to learn. So God Almighty said, no, I did not create them. I gave them names. Psalm 147 verse 4 and 1 Corinthians 15:41. Psalm 147 verse 4, 1 Corinthians 15:41. I hope you are with your chapter.
Yes.
I hope you are with your Bible
yes.
to take down this scripture so that
yes.
you go back and study them
Amen.
Like the Berean Christian.
Yes.
Read Psalm 147, verse number 4.
Hallelujah. 147, I read verse 4.
Yes, sir.
He telleth the number of the stars.
Uh-huh.
He calleth them all by their names.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God Almighty said He's the one that named them. I didn't tell anybody the name.
Uh-huh.
So if you hear anybody calling name of star here, the devil gave them name. God is the one that named what He created.
Yes, sir.
Adam did not name them. Adam named animal.
Yes.
God named stars. He knows the name. 1 Corinthians 15:41.
1 Corinthians 15:41.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
There is one glory of the sun,
uh-huh.
and another glory of the moon,
uh-huh.
another glory of the stars.
Uh-huh.
For one star differeth from another star in glory.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
God Almighty said, I know the difference.
Yes.
You are just saying stars, but I know which is which.
Uh-huh.
If one drops, I know which one drops.
Yes.
He's teaching us how to worship Him.
He's
teaching us how to produce tears from our hands. He's teaching us how to shake, how to tremble before Him. That boldness of men putting hand in their pocket when they are worshiping God. If they know that God knows all the stars and their name, they will remove their hand from their pocket. I begin to worship God. They will lift up those hands to the Lord and give God the praise. God Almighty, I named them. Therefore, stars must never be worshipped. Beware of the idolatry of horoscope. Horoscope is the devil's invention to trap the souls of men. And they attach it to our idol, which is birthday. The devil knows that we love birthday. So he came through our idol of birthday to give us star, to give us horoscope. They call it Starius. There's Starius, there's Aries. There are names. Can you remember them? There are Saturn. There are some stars.
Yes.
You remember now? They are there.
Jupiter,
they are there. They have this horoscope that they used to attach to our idols. So you see, when in those days, as I was growing as a teenager, they would say, what is your own star? Like me now, that was born in March, they would say, it's Aries. I can't forget because I grew with it. It was important. So all the Aries, we form club. We love ourselves. We form confraternity of all the Arians. All the Tarius, and all of them are represented with one animal, one team for the other.
Yes,
child of Scorpio.
Yes.
That is Scorpio.
Yes,
November.
Yes.
I was in it. I was deep in it. The Lord is teaching us. He's delivering us. People will be delivered. Horoscope is satanic. God Almighty said today, you will know about it. Second Kings. Second Kings chapter 17. 16 to 20. It's a list, my child. Second Kings 17, 16 to 20. Ezekiel 18. 16 to 18. Deuteronomy 4:19. Amos 5:26. Jude 1:13. Revelation 3:1. Anyone you don't remember, I will remind you, son.
Let's begin to go.
Amen.
2 Kings 17.
2 Kings chapter 17.
Yes, sir.
I read 2 Kings chapter 16, 17.
16 to 20.
I got to take 17, then 16 to 20.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
17. 16 to 20.
And they left all the commandments of the Lord their God,
uh-huh,
and made them molten images,
uh-huh,
even two calves,
uh-huh,
and made a groove,
yes,
and worshipped all the hosts of heaven, uh-huh, and served Baal.
Uh-huh.
And they caused their sons and their daughters to pass through the fire,
yes,
and used divination and enchantments,
uh-huh,
and sold themselves to do evil in the sight of the Lord,
uh-huh,
to provoke him to anger.
Yes.
Therefore the Lord was very angry with Israel,
yes,
and removed them out of his sight.
Uh-huh.
There was none left but the tribe of Judah only.
The worshippers.
That's right. And also Judah kept not the commandments of the Lord,
uh-huh,
their God,
uh-huh,
but walked in the statutes of Israel, which they made.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord rejected all the seed of, yes, Israel,
too,
and afflicted them,
uh-huh,
and delivered them into the hand of spoilers. So he had cast them out of his sight.
Tell God, don't play with God. Once you begin to worship creature, automatically you are discarded from God's presence. That's why I don't understand why preachers are emphasizing on things, on blessing, on prosperity, on cars. They go, you hear preachers calling name of big, big cars from the pulpits. Lamborghini. They call name of cars to be, give people the spirit of covetousness instead of calling name of the Lord of hosts and teaching men how to fear God. God Almighty, they began to abandon God and began to worship the host of heaven. Tell you God, the host of heaven, the stars are there. Sun, moon, they are called the host of heaven. They are to be worshiping God. But people, yes, began to carry them as sights of heaven to them because it glitters. Beware of things that glitter. Beware of shine. God Almighty said a lot of these stones, all these shine things, beware of them so that you don't worship them. The Bible says they left God and began to worship. And once you're worshiping these things, automatically you're worshiping Baal.
Mm-hmm. I'm served Baal.
You're serving him. You're not serving God. You're worshiping the devil. God Almighty said, beware of the idolatry of stars, of horoscope.
Yes.
Read on some. Go to the next.
Ezekiel 18:16-18.
Ezekiel chapter number 18. 16 to 18. Thank you, Jesus.
16 to 18 of Ezekiel 18.
Yes.
Neither have oppressed any.
Uh-huh.
Neither have withholden the pledge. Neither have spoiled by violence, but have given his bread to the hungry.
And Ezekiel chapter number 18.
Yes.
16 to 20.
Ezekiel 18:16 to 20.
Yes.
Neither have oppressed any.
Yes.
Had not withholden the pledge, neither had spoiled by violence,
uh-huh,
but had given his bread to the hungry, yes, and had covered the naked with a garment. Verse 17. That had taken off his hand from the poor.
Yes.
That had not received usury nor increase.
Yes.
Had executed my judgments,
uh-huh,
and walked in my statutes.
Yes.
He shall not die for the iniquity of his father.
Uh-huh.
He shall surely live.
Yes.
As for his father, because he had cruelly oppressed,
yes,
spoiled his brother by violence,
uh-huh,
and did that which is no good among his people.
Yes.
Lo, even he shall die in his iniquity.
Yes.
Yes, say ye.
Yes.
Why? Doth not the son bear the iniquity of the father?
Uh-huh.
When the son had done that which is lawful and right, and had not kept all my statutes,
yes,
and had done them, he shall surely live.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I must have missed that verse of scripture. Look at 15.
He that he had not eaten upon the mountains,
uh-huh,
neither had lifted up his eyes to the idols of the house of Israel,
uh-huh,
had not defied his neighbor's wife.
The Bible says Israel was used to these idols. And God is giving us a list of those people that are not worshipping idols. Child of God, when we begin to worship all these stars, we are going into the idolatry of Israel. They are the ones that God is using to teach us how much he hates the worship of stars. So I'll go to the next verse. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 19. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Deuteronomy chapter 4, I read verse 19.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Unless thou lift up thine eyes unto heaven.
Yes.
And when thou seest the sun and the moon and the stars, even all the host of heaven, should just be driven to worship them and serve them, which the Lord thy God had divided unto all nations under the whole heaven.
Child, that every nation has stars. But because they are beautiful, because they are fascinating, you begin to wonder. The Bible said John saw the mother of harlots and was filled with great admiration. We have a heart that is inclined to idolatry. We have a heart that can easily worship things. That is why I can see people that say they are so much in love that they go and do blood oath. They suck each other's blood and say, "You will not leave me, I will not leave you." And then when one of them discovers that that one is unfaithful, they can commit murder and suicide. They say, "Two of us will die. Nobody's going to get you." That is how far people can worship. They worship their love affair. They worship relationship. God Almighty is calling you, and now it is time for us to be aware of what we put so much admiration in.
Yes, sir.
Because people are worshiping stars. Not just physical stars. People are worshiping human beings that they call stars. They name them celebrities.
Yes.
What do you mean of celebrity? Celebrity is celebrating somebody. And we're not to celebrate any man, but to celebrate only God. And so when you're talking about celebrity, this person is a star. Child of God, we're worshiping men. And God said there's a punishment. I will cut you off my sight. I will bring affliction. I will do this to you. I will do that to you. Many troubles we are going through is because of our idol worship of human beings. Human preachers that you call celebrities. Men of God. Touch not. You put them in celebrity status. A height that God didn't put them. God Almighty said in his sight, nothing like celebrity. We are going to see what God talks about these things.
Amos 5:26.
Yes, sir.
But they have burned the tabernacle of your Moloch.
Yes.
And Chuan, your images.
Yes.
The star of your God, which ye made to yourself.
Child of God, beware of that word star.
Yes.
It has a way of charming the hearts. It is attractive.
Yes.
If you go back to the verse that we just read, Deuteronomy, the Bible says, you lift up your eyes. Yes. That's why God said, look into my eyes so that you will have light.
Oh.
Once you look into the stars, God Almighty said, darkness is coming. You cannot have light. All your thoughts will be filled with darkness. The Lord God Almighty is saying, we are the ones that set it up ourselves. Because we like it. We admire it. Your makeup, we want to look like a particular star. There are some clothes that they are doing now. They are making designer clothes. They put a particular face of a woman on the dress.
Yes.
And you want to exhibit it, because that person is a star. You want to identify with that person. Not only that person has a monetary spirit. There's a demon supervising that person to attract souls. There are charms that the enemy puts on that picture to attract people. That is why you see such pictures. They have women that do it. They are called lesbians. They are called lesbians. I know what I am talking about, by the Spirit of the Living God. Beware of clothes that have women that do like this, that have makeup, that have hair. You put it on your chest. It's not ordinary. It has been enchantments have gone to the picture. Enchantments, the divinations have gone to charm the souls of men and women. God Almighty said, beware of these images that we admire. So Jude 1:13.
Jude chapter 1, verse 13.
Yes, sir.
Raging waves of the sea,
foaming
out their own shame.
Yes.
Wandering stars,
To
whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever.
Child of God, we will understand these wandering stars later. So you will understand the reason for stars.
Yes.
You will not appreciate it because it's referring to angels. Revelation chapter 3, verse 1.
Revelation 3, verse 1. And unto the angel of the church in Sardis write, this is yet he that have the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know thy works, that thou hast a name that thou livest and art dead.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In this place, you understand what stars and who the stars are. The seven stars are seven angels. God Almighty said, beware Or people that say they are reading stars, they are powerless, they are demonic, Satan sponsored them, mm-hmm. Satan employed them.
Yes.
Nobody can read your star,
yes.
Because you don't have a star.
Ah,
yeah, Kalanawa, we don't have star. Culturally, we don't need star. You will see that God Almighty will tell you, we don't need star. We are not stars. Isaiah 47:13. Starry stars are satanic. They are powerless. They have been employed in the company of Satan. Isaiah 47 verse number 13.
Isaiah 47 verse 13.
Yes.
Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsels.
Uh-huh.
Let now the astrologers,
uh-huh.
The stargazers,
uh-huh.
The monthly prognosticators,
uh-huh.
Stand up.
Holy Ghost has
and
drama.
Self be free from
this. Is this what Holy Ghost is doing to you? When you don't read Bible, you only read Psalm. You will not know this one.
Prognosticators,
yes,
stand up,
uh-huh.
And save thee from these things,
uh-huh.
That shall come upon thee.
The Lord said, God to study that, palm readers, God Almighty said, they will not save you on the day. The day of judgment, when he's going to come with his fire, star readers, palm readers, they cannot save us. Beware of reading all the predictions about all the tarots. And you begin to be proud because Satan has a way of making your character totally with it. He has a way of putting your character in that thing.
Yes.
And you begin to believe it. And then the spirit behind the tarots and the Scorpio and all the Aries will now come and begin to monitor you. That is why you must beware of the social media games you play, all these OMG games you play on Facebook. And you are proud. They will tell you, let me tell you who you are. This is your good side. This is your bad side. And you say, see Facebook. Facebook knows me. Child of God, you are working with evil spirits. They are reading your life. I'm telling you something that you like. Why? To have access.
Access.
To have access into your life. Are you dreaming stupid dreams? How can I? But when God gives you a revelation you don't hear, you only hear the one they give to you. Every game on Facebook, every game on social media is satanic. It's demonic. It's sponsored by Queen of the Coast. As you put yourself under their power, they will control your destiny. Beware of following all these star readers, stargazers, crystal ball. Beware of prophets. Stop going to prophetic meetings because all of them read all the balls. Most of the prophets, if not entered their inner special room, if you go there, you will weep at what you will see there. You'll be shocked at what you will see there. They all have seen one. I've entered the fourth prophet's office and I know what I saw there. They have a crystal ball. The Lord told me, look around, check well. And that was the end of me and that person. Child of God, you will not know because these people have some form of godliness. But God Almighty had mercy on me. He knows that I love to minister to people.
Yes.
I want people to know the Lord, to teach people how to serve God and
yes.
How to worship God.
Yes.
And God saw the innocency of my heart and said, come out of this thing. There is an inner room that they have. Where they go and conjure. They stay in that room and see everybody's spirit in that service. I'm not talking about the fake ones. The original fake. The fake ones are the ones that go and interview people and get information. There is original fake. That one doesn't do interview. That one has a crystal ball. My consultant. Now when he enters that room, he sees everybody like a skeleton. Yeah, he sees in between the lines. He goes beyond the flesh. He sees you as a child. Beware of people that talk and see things. Most of them are operating under the spirit of necromancy.
Yes.
They are stargazers. They are that name that my son could not pronounce.
Prognosticators.
Hallelujah.
They are there. God knows them.
Yes.
And God will expose them.
Amen.
I'm not praying for their salvation. I pray for their exposure.
Amen.
If they're not exposed, some of us will never be free.
Yes.
I can live black or something. I'm not praying for their repentance. They should not repent. They should be disgraced. There are some worshippers of Satan that will never repent. I can live black or something. Why? They have sold their soul to darkness. They have made up their minds to serve the devil. They have enjoyed the tunnel. They want the big bag at the auditorium. They want TV station. They have made up their mind that they will follow Satan to the end. I can live black or something. Know how you pray for them that they're going to repent. Beware of feeling that you are righteous. God Almighty said these people must be exposed.
Amen.
God, they are disgraced people of God. God will deliver us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
according to Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. 3:1 Ecclesiastes. There is a reason why God made everything.
Yes.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1.
What does it say?
To everything there is a season,
uh-huh,
and a time to every purpose under the heaven.
Everything that God created has a purpose. So, why? The heavens are declaring. Oh, hallelujah. When he wants to show us his wonder in our lives, he says, go and count. So we have a series of scripture. Genesis 15:5. Genesis 22:17. Genesis 26 verse 4. Exodus 32:13. Deuteronomy chapter number 1 verse 10. Deuteronomy chapter number 10 verse 22. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse number 62. First Chronicles 27, 23. Feast dwellers, we are not tired of scripture.
So,
Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 23. Nehemiah 9, 23.
Genesis chapter 15. I read verse 5.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Verse 5. And he brought him forth abroad and said,
yes,
look now toward heaven,
uh-huh,
and tell the stars,
yes,
is thou be able to number them?
Uh-huh.
And he said unto him,
yes,
so shall thy seed be.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When God Almighty wants us to be dazed, to be amazed, about this blessing, he will say, go and count. Can you count the stars? If you can count the stars, then you have that is what I want to do for you. That's what I want to give to you. Say to Abraham, I know right now you have nothing. Go outside and count. That was why the Bible says Abraham hoped against hope. He believed when there was nothing to believe about. And God Almighty said it was accounted unto him for righteousness. Why? There was nothing. Yet he was counting. And today, we are seeds of Abraham. We are part of the family of Abraham. Bible says, in him, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Child of God, God Almighty uses stars when he wants to wow us. When he wants to daze us. He said, go and count. He needs to describe uncountable. Next verse.
Genesis chapter 22, verse 17.
Yes, sir.
That in blessing I will bless thee.
Uh-huh.
And in multiplying I will multiply thy seed of the stars of heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And as the sand which is upon the seashore,
yes,
and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies.
Hallelujah. Because he said that his seed will be as the stars of the heaven. That means uncountable. Can you count all the Christians, all those who have surrendered to Jesus and those that are yet to come? They are not countable. But go soon, the Lord said that they are like stars.
Yes.
Not that we are stars,
we are
but
like
it is to know the number.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 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 Next verse, sir.
Genesis 36, verse 4.
Yes, sir.
And I will make thy seed to multiply as the stars of heaven. And will give unto thy seed all these countries. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed.
Amen. All the nations of the earth be blessed. It is coming from a family called the Abraham family. Child of God, God Almighty said, we are not stars. You better begin to pick this truth.
Yes.
He uses it to count number. Go to the next verse in the book of Exodus.
Chapter
32. 13.
Verse 13.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants, to whom thou swearest thy, by thy own self, and tellest unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have spoken of,
Will I give
unto your seed, and they shall inherit it forever.
Hallelujah! Amen. God Almighty, these are confirmations.
Yes, sir.
These are witnesses.
Yes, sir.
We have to use witnesses. That is why I cannot use only one witness of in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Ghost to prove. There is only one. God Almighty, it must be two or three witnesses to establish a thing. God Almighty is establishing to us that when you hear that he's talking about stars, it's to count your number.
Yes.
To teach us about innumerable company of
angels.
Read the next verse, sir.
Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 10.
Yes, sir.
The Lord your God hath multiplied you.
Yes.
And behold, here are this day as the stars of heaven.
It is comparative.
Yes.
For multitude.
As sly as a fox. As betrayer as Judas. It is for comparison. Read us, sir.
Deuteronomy 10:22.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Thy fathers went down into Egypt with 70 persons.
Yes.
And now the Lord thy God had made thee as the stars of heaven.
Hallelujah. Yes. Are you seeing what God is doing here?
Yes.
Are you learning something?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Next verse,
Deuteronomy 28, verse 62.
And
here shall be left few in number,
Whereas
Syria has the stars of heaven for multitude, because thou wouldest not obey the voice of the Lord thy God.
Amen. God Almighty said, I can drop from great number to small number. I can remove. The only thing that moves God, that makes him angry, is sin. Once we leave God, God says, and we react.
He shall be left few in number.
Don't be thinking that God is blind at the sin of the world.
No.
God is not blind.
God is
He's just slow to anger.
Yes.
He's a merciful God.
Yes.
He has given us space to repent and amend our ways.
Yes.
He's not slack.
No.
He doesn't condone sin.
Uh-uh.
Even matter of grace. Grace has expiry dates.
Yes.
And once grace stops, nobody can intercede. Nobody can intercept. God Almighty said that is the risk of postponing repentance. It is risky, for you don't know when it will expire. You don't know when the Lord will say enough. Death angel, pick up. We don't know when he's going to send the death angel. That's why we do not waste time. Because when you hear his voice, harden not your heart. God Almighty is going to be softened towards him.
Amen.
That he's not going to change his mind about his promises. He said, you were many before, but as you were committing sin, doing evil, I dropped you to few. The Lord will have mercy on us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Son.
1 Chronicles 27, verse 23.
But
David took not the number of them from 20 years old and under.
Yes.
Because the Lord had said
he
would increase Israel like to the stars of the heavens.
So we have established it.
Yes, sir.
The number one reason why the Lord created stars is to use it as a purpose for us to be able to count what he is doing in our lives. What he can do is for number counting.
Yes. Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 23.
Hallelujah.
Your children also multiplies now as the stars of heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it's stars of heaven.
Yes.
So there are no stars in hell. There's no star here with us. The stars are here, are up there. So you cannot claim what God didn't give to you.
Yes.
Stars are there. We are not stars. The next time you begin to say, I am a star, I have star, you are worshipping the devil. God is not there. You will learn more today.
And brought them into the land concerning which thou hast promised to their fathers.
Amen.
You should go and possess this. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord said, number two reason why he created star is to describe the tribes of Israel.
Hallelujah.
The people that he passed through to bring forth this message to us. God will always use somebody like his using global author today to reach people all over the world. God Almighty passed through Israel to give us his word. So go to the book of Genesis 37 verse 9 and then Revelation 12 1. Revelation chapter 12 verse number 1. Start with Genesis 37 9. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Genesis chapter 37, verse 9.
Yes, sir.
And the cherubim spread out their wings on high and covered with their wings over the mercy seats.
Yes.
With their faces one to another. Even to the mercy seat, what?
Yes.
We are the faces of the cherubims.
Yes. Genesis 37, 9. What did you read, my child?
Exodus
37. The Lord is with you.
Genesis chapter 37, verse 9. And he dreamed yet another dream and told it his brethren and said, behold, I have dreamed a dream more.
Yes.
And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me.
God Almighty said, that time the 12th has not come. He said he's using this to describe the 12 tribes of Israel.
Yes.
It's also Revelation 12 1. It's also in the book of James 1 verse 1. That's the third verse. Revelation 12 1 and then James 1 1.
Revelation chapter 12 verse 1.
Verse 1.
Thank Revelation you. 12 verse 1. Yes. And there appeared a great wonder in heaven. A woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet. And upon her head a crown of 12 stars.
So the Lord God Almighty said, this place is referring to the 12 tribes of Israel. So look at it to confirm it that it is 12 tribes.
James chapter 1 verse 1.
James,
a servant of God and of all and of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
To the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad.
Greeting. God Almighty said that there are 12 tribes.
Hallelujah.
And you and I know that he said Israel is my firstborn. Child of God, we cannot do replacement theory.
At all.
We cannot push away the physical Israel. Hallelujah. The Lord is confirming. We cannot push away the physical Israel. The Lord Almighty said, yes, they are the senior brother and I've been there.
Yes, sir.
But God Almighty needed us, the junior brother, to come back home.
Amen.
Sent you to the farm. God Almighty is calling you now. We cannot forget the physical Israel. I've been there. And God has not forgotten his covenant with them. Because God said, I'm going to pick 12,000 from each tribe and will make heaven, apart from those who would on their own come under the salvation of the Lord Jesus Christ. God Almighty is coming one night to know that when he talks about 12 stars, he's referring to the 12 tribes of Israel.
Amen.
His firstborn.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three reason for stars. It is to describe angels. God uses stars to describe angels. So we have a series of scriptures again to read some.
Yes,
Judges 5:20. Job 38:7. Isaiah 14:13. Obadiah 1:4. Revelation chapter 1, verse 16 and 20. Revelation chapter 1, 16 and 20. Revelation chapter 2, verse 1. Revelation chapter 12, verse 4. 2, 1, then 12, 4. Don't be bored. Don't be tired because many of you have 100 prayer points. You want God to read all. Hey, Kalaya. God said, read my own point.
Yes, sir.
This is my own point.
First.
Hallelujah. First.
Yes.
Read it, sir.
Judges chapter 5. I read verse 20.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
They fought from heaven. The stars in their courses fought against Sisera.
These are angels.
Yes.
God Almighty said, that is one of the reasons I created angels to stars to use them, to use stars to describe angels.
Job chapter 38, verse 7.
Yes.
When the morning stars sang together,
yes,
and all the sons of God shouted for joy.
So you can see that angels are morning stars. Because God Almighty is going to debunk something today.
Amen.
About morning star.
Amen.
who will see the glory of God today.
Amen.
So they are angels. Yes. Morning stars, they are angels. Yes, go ahead.
Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 13.
Yes.
For thou hast said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven.
Yes.
I will exalt my throne above the stars of God.
Uh-huh.
And will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north.
Yes.
Amen.
So that is Lucifer. Yes. That is the devil who wants to be exalted above all the angels that God created. God Almighty said he uses it to describe angels. Read on.
Obadiah chapter 1 verse 4.
Yes.
Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, and though thou set thy nest among the stars, then shall I bring thee down, saith the Lord.
But God is talking still about the devil.
Yes.
God is saying that the angels are stars, and that he knows how to separate them because he named them. He knows their name. Like in the case of the devil, it's almost Lucifer. God Almighty said, Revelation chapter 1, verse 16 and 20.
Revelation chapter 1.
There are stars there.
Yes. And he had in his right hand seven stars. And out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword. And his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength.
Child of God, those seven stars are angels, confirming it in verse 20.
The mystery of the seven stars which thou sawest in my right hand, and the seven golden golden candlesticks.
Yes.
The seven stars are the angels of the seven churches. And the seven candlesticks which thou sawest are the seven churches.
So you can see that God uses stars to describe angels. Yes. Go ahead.
And unto the angel of the church of Ephesus write.
Revelation 2,
Yes, sir. Unto the angel of the church of Ephesus write. This thing saith he that holdeth the seven stars in his right hand, who walketh in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks.
That's confirmation again.
That's right.
That these seven stars are angels.
Revelation chapter 2, verse 4.
Yes, sir.
And he still drew the third part of the stars of heaven, and did cast them to the earth.
Yes.
And the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born.
Child of God, we are emphasizing on stars.
Yes.
The Bible said that the devil used his tail and knocked down one third of the stars, that's of the angels. Are you getting something today, teacher?
Yes.
So beware of talking about I'm a star. He is a star. Somebody wants to steal my star. These things are satanic. Because God Almighty said we must know the root of our problem.
Yes.
For the Bible says we are justified by our words. We are also condemned by our words.
Yes.
God Almighty wants to deliver us from self-condemnation.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible said these are the three reasons. So we are not stars. What are we? We are to shine. We are called to shine. Through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So if Jesus Christ is inside of us, automatically we will shine.
Hallelujah.
Because he is the one that is the shining star.
Yes.
We are going to see it.
Hallelujah.
He is the one.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1. We are not stars. Daniel 12:3. Matthew 5:15-16. These are confirmations.
Hallelujah.
That we are not stars.
Yes.
But we are to shine. Isaiah 61.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1. Arise, shine,
shine,
for the light is gone.
Hallelujah.
The glory of the Lord is risen upon thee.
Yes, sir. Someone say the glory of the Lord.
The glory of the Lord.
Shine of God, the glory of the Lord. We cannot shine. We cannot even lift ourselves from the ground. It is automatic. Once we arise and stand for Jesus, we will automatically shine. It doesn't need prayer point. You don't need anointing oil. You don't need handkerchief. It's automatic. It's just like the door. In the air, in the hotels have that door. Airports have that door. That when you are coming, shops, automatically it will open. It has been wired to open. Once a body or something comes near it, it has been censored. God Almighty is automatic. Once you say, I arise for Jesus, you will
shine.
Your shining is not because of jewelry or hair or painting. You are sharing because the glory of the Lord has a reason upon you. And the God of God has a reason why we shine. Look at another verse.
Daniel chapter
12,
verse 3.
Yes, sir.
And they that be white shall shine as the brightness of the firmament.
They that be white shall shine as
the brightness of the firmament.
We are not brightness of firmament. It is ash. Is it to compare?
Yes, sir.
They that be wise shall shine us
with the brightness of the firmament.
Uh-huh.
And they that turn many to righteousness.
And they that turn many to righteousness
as the stars forever and ever.
Child of God, we are not stars. God is competent of us, but comparity. He shall shine us the stars. So our shining is because we are winning souls.
That's it.
We are witnessing for Jesus Christ. So anybody who knows witnessing for Jesus Christ, you don't have this shine you put on yourself. You are not shining. You are not shining before God. God's eye is not our eye. Our own is full of evil. His own is full of light. Our shining is when we are preaching. When we are doing the will of God, we'll begin to shine automatically. So nobody can block your shine. Nobody has power to block the shine of a child of God. Nobody. It's not scriptural. He wants to cover me. No. Nobody can cover your glory. Because it is called the glory of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Not my glory. He is my glory. And the lifter up of my head. Child of God, beware of the words you use. They make you proud. That's why you do selfie. It's from the word star. Star, selfie, self, projection of self. Once people hear star, that is why, oh, Calibra Kosutaya, that is why birthday is dangerous. They say, sir, it is your day. To Kasaibo, it is your day. You are the star of the day. It's about you. Star of the month. This month belongs to you. These are satanic, demonic things. We are worshiping men.
Yes.
We are conjuring and bringing the spirits of the star, these stars of Aries and go to God and begin to work together against the life of that person without knowing. Beware of all this crown. That is why God can never ever support all these things that they are doing. All this idol, American idol, Nigerian idol, Miss Nigeria, Miss World. And they come and fetch a crown on the head and make a person look like a star, like a queen. Child of God, God is not doing all those queen things. You don't know those queen things. Beware of how you cause your heart to be connected to the devil.
Yes.
That was meant to pray the Holy Ghost. And you let your heart be connected to the will of God.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that God said, until we begin to do his will, we cannot shine.
Yes.
Mark chapter 5, verse 15 to 16.
Matthew 5, 16, 15 to 16.
Why
not do men light a candle and put it under a bushel?
Yes.
But on a candlestick
and
give up light unto all that are in the house.
Yes.
Let your light so shine before men and they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
The Bible says, let your light. There is a light that is in us. Yes. Because Christ is in us. He is the one that is the hope of glory. The Bible said, Colossians 1:22 says, Christ in me is the hope of glory. When he is in us, child of God, we shine. When we are witnessing, we are shining. It is called the light. He said, ye are the light of the world. God Almighty said, when we begin to shine, God said, people will see the good works and their attention. Their attention will move to Jesus Christ. They will never give us anything. They cannot call us star. Look at what that person did to me after my ministration. He said, don't you know that you're a star? My shoulder pad hooked up. And because my steps changed. That's why some people wonder when they're all these gospel singers, they want to dress like stars. They want to be. That's why people allow them to dress. They say they are stars. That's how stars dress. They have to show some of the body. Today, the greatest prostitutes we have are the stars.
Yes.
All the Rihannas, all the Beyonces, All these Nollywood actresses in Nigeria, all of them, they are all prostitutes. Why? When they go at the social media and open their body, they have thousands of likes. They mentor girls. They are the one that mentor Chidinma. That girl that killed, that allegedly killed that billionaire.
Yes.
They mentored. Nollywood actresses, all these tonto, Tiki and Co. They mentored her. And she said, what do they have that I don't have? Is it not breast? I'm going to bring her own breast. Is it not buttocks? I'm going to bring her my own buttocks. All these so-called celebrities that we call, they are sponsored by Queen of the Coast. To mentor little girls. But God will restore our daughter.
Amen.
The mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God Almighty is going to look down from heaven. He's going to hear this message. Amen. He's going to pass it to all the look across this world. And mothers will get back to their knees and begin to pray and cry to God and get back their daughters. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God Almighty said, our shining is in God.
Yes, sir.
You're not to take any glory.
At all.
All the gospel singers in Nigeria, all of you, all the Sinach and all the Mercy Chima, yes, all of you, go and repent.
Yes, sir.
Change your dressing. You are not a star. You are not a celebrity. You are nothing. It is Jesus that is a shine. Repent. For God Almighty is angry with all the people that are using his name to claim stardom. He never calls us stars. I say, hello, son. And there's a song we sing in Nigeria. And Talibra Kosote. He said, people, they ask me, say,
yes,
sir. When did they beg you shine? I just they tell them, say, now Jesus, they make me shine. Oh,
I shine.
The Lord is calling you and it is time for us to know that he is the
shiner. Yes.
When you carry your shoe and come out, hey, beautiful shoe, somebody has shined it. There is a Jesus. God was taking glory. He said, if there you remove your focus from me, you want to take the place of my glory, I will reduce it to nothing. I can bring you down from any height. I'm not using my name and making money. I cannot go so there. I'm getting fame. And I'll give you red carpet. And you are stepping on it. Have you not heard about your mentor David? That when he wanted to drink water from a particular river, and three men went to risk their life to bring the water. He didn't drink the water. He poured the water. I said, I cannot drink the blood of men. And you are collecting the glory of God. And they're clapping for you. Everybody is standing for you. They are using their camera to video you. And now you are using it. You are using it now to corrupt the whole world. God Almighty is calling us to begin to repent. Pastors' wives, you are using your position to corrupt people like a neighbor or something. I wish people can know how to pray. You are using your position to corrupt the souls of men. God Almighty is coming out to repent.
Amen.
Pastors' wives to repent. God will sing God to repent. And then you're not an Easter. Now look at it. It's even drama people are even becoming star. Drama. Since when did drama want to come and become star? I can never because did you see any drama in the Bible?
No.
I can't. Who is acting drama? I can never consult. God Almighty is going to intervene.
Amen.
He's going to intervene.
Amen.
In the house of God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Enough of this nonsense that we are doing. That's why we like things that are shining up and down. We remove the light of God. We remove bright lights and begin to put red lights. And purple lights. We need to put blue lights. God Almighty is calling on us to become spiritually minded.
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want us to begin to quote into the scriptures. The Bible says, Jesus Christ is the only star.
Hallelujah.
Difference between Jesus being a star and the morning star of the angels. Even of the devil. Because the devil is a morning star. Let's read that one before we talk about Jesus. Let's read that same Isaiah 14. 12 and 13, and then Luke chapter 10, verse 18. Why the devil is called the morning star? We have seen that it's an angel, but let us read the scripture that pertains to him directly.
Yes, sir.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 13.
12 and 13.
12 and 13.
Yes.
How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
Yes.
Son of the morning.
Uh-huh.
How art thou cut down to the ground?
Yes. God Almighty said there's a Lucifer that is called the son of the morning.
Yes.
Morning star. We want to know why he's answering morning star. Because people don't know the real name of Jesus. We know his name today.
Hallelujah.
Because I heard an American singer singing Star of the Morning. And I like that song.
Yes.
I've known that song for years.
Yes.
Now I know he was worshiping Satan.
Yes.
Because Jesus is not Son of the Morning.
Hallelujah.
I've got to see Jesus. Look at this.
Verse 13.
Look.
For thou hast said in thine heart,
yes,
I will ascend into heaven.
Uh-huh.
I will exalt my throne above the stars of God.
Uh-huh.
I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north.
Yes, that is what he said. Because he wants to assume the position of God. He has always wanted to be like God. So he went to mentor Adam and Eve. You will also be like God.
Yes.
And since he couldn't achieve it, he wants to enter into God's children. So the same way he's entering into us. To want to make us to fight God. To claim stardom when God never called us stars. That word is going to die in our lips. For we are not stars and we have no star.
Yes,
read on.
Luke chapter
10.
Luke chapter 18.
And he said unto them,
uh-huh,
I beheld Satan,
uh-huh,
as lightning fall from heaven.
Yes.
Amen.
God Almighty said Satan fell as lightning. That means he was a star.
Uh-huh.
And that was Satan. He was a star.
Yes.
He fell as lightning from heaven. Yes. So Jesus Christ is the star.
Hallelujah.
He's the only star.
Hallelujah.
He's the one that should be acknowledged.
Hallelujah.
So you cannot have award night.
Uh-huh.
Nobody to award anything. He is the owner of all awards. Look at the scriptures. Numbers 24:17. Matthew 2:7-9-10. 1 Peter 1:19. John 9:5. Revelation 2:28. Revelation 22:16. Revelation 2:28.
Mm-hmm.
Revelation 22:16. So let's go to Numbers 24:17. Jesus Christ is the only star.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Numbers 24, verse 17.
Yes.
I shall see him.
Yes.
But not now.
Uh-huh.
I shall behold him.
Yes.
But not now.
Uh-huh.
There shall come a star out of Jacob.
Uh-huh.
And a scepter shall rise out of Israel.
Hallelujah.
And shall smite the corners of Moab.
Uh-huh.
And destroy all the children of Sheph.
He is the one that is referred to as a star with a capital letter S.
Yes.
That's the only star we know. Star. Of course, Galatia. No human being. Child of God, beware of wanting to rupture that with God. That is why God's scripture, if you want to get God's heart, quote Numbers 23:19. If you quote Numbers 23:19, God will kiss you. You can how people want God to kiss them? But you begin to go into Numbers 23:19.
Numbers 23, verse 19.
What does it say?
God is not a
God is not a man.
That's he should lie.
That he should lie.
That is the son of man.
Shall he not make it good? God Almighty said, if you want me to hug you and kiss you, every morning when you get up, you shout, Ibu Choco, Ibu Gimado. Ibu Choco, Ibu Gimado. I'll find a mega, Ibu Choco.
You become.
at you a second time, quote that scripture to me. God doesn't want to ever be compared to man. It is an insult. Once you begin to compare God to man, he gives you a reprobate mind. Jump to the book of Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1. Read verse 18.
Read chapter 1, verse 18.
Yes, sir.
For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men.
Uh-huh.
Who hold the truth in unrighteousness.
Yes. Amen. Keep on going.
Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them.
Uh-huh.
For God hath showed it unto them.
Yes.
For the invisible things of him, from the creation of the world,
yes,
are clearly seen.
Yes.
Being understood by the things that are made.
Yes.
Even his eternal power and Godhead.
Yes.
So that they are without excuse.
So go to verse 27.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh.
And likewise also the men.
No, go to 25, son.
25.
Yes, son. Son.
Who changed the truth of God into a lie.
And changed the truth of God into a lie.
And worship as
and worship and serve the creature more than the creator. Who is blessed forever. Child of God, remember, he said, if you want to touch his mind, don't compare him to man. Don't compare God to creature. God said, if you try it, you will attract his anger. Look at what he did to them in 28.
Verse 28.
Yes. And even as they did not like to retain God,
their knowledge,
uh-huh,
God gave
them over to a reprobate man.
Which are not convenient.
When you find preachers, when you find celebrities, they are called as celebrities, when you find them doing as they like, they have a reprobate mind. God has left them. There may be no room for repentance. They are beginning to worship themselves. It will be very hard for them to repent. Why? God himself is supervising their heart. So this is what? You will not know the truth. You are condemned. Beware of how you think you can pray for people. God said that people that give reprobate mind. Do you know those who are not worshiping themselves? The preachers who worship their doom. Do you know them? God Almighty said, beware. There are people that he will not allow to retain God. You're taking jobs. You're taking jobs. You will not remember God. You will become a Pharisee. Pharisees, they read Bible.
Yes.
They taught God.
Yes.
But they didn't have the knowledge of God. They didn't have the speech of God. They are heading for hell.
Yes.
They are white shepherds. God Almighty said, beware not to have a reprobate mind. When creatures begin to say they are somebody, who are you to call us a star? God said, I am the star. We cannot be stars. No human being is a star. God is the star. We are going to repent today. In the name of Jesus Christ. So what are you now?
Matthew chapter 2, 7-19.
Yes, sir.
And verse 7.
Uh-huh.
And then Herod,
yes,
when he had privily called the wise men,
uh-huh,
the mind of them diligently one time the star appeared.
Yes.
Verse 9. When they had a king, they departed.
Uh-huh.
And lo, the star which they saw in the east,
uh-huh,
went before them,
uh-huh,
till it came and stood where the young child was.
So then this is the only star.
Yes.
The physical star stayed in the star. The physical star came upon the spiritual star, the only star that should be worshipped.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
When they saw the star, child of God, this is the only star that should give us joy.
Rejoice.
Not any gospel singer, not any footballer, not any billionaire. Beware of how you are calling yourself a star. Your baby is not a star. Beware of star readers. Who told you? That prophet told you. That prophet told you. This star is this child. child is a special child. This child is a star. Yes, this child has a star. I can see a star. And this child, they are necromancers. They are working spirit of divination. They are witches and wizards. They are satanic from the pit of hell. God Almighty said, no human being is a star. And we don't have stars.
We don't.
This lie is coming down finally. We are learning the truth about stars. In the name of Jesus Christ. Psalm 1 Peter 1:19. Holy Ghost, we give you glory.
1 Peter 1:19.
Yes, sir.
But with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Who finally was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for you.
Hallelujah. Child of God Almighty said he is the star. Jesus Christ is the star. And we will continue to recognize him as the star. In the name of Jesus Christ. Go to Revelation. Or John. John 9:5.
Yes, sir.
John chapter 9.
Verse 5.
Yes,
sir.
As long as I'm in the world,
yes,
I am the light of the world.
The Lord said he is the light.
Yes,
so we have to look into him.
Yes.
When we look upon Jesus, we will be filled with light.
Amen.
It is that light that shines.
Yes.
Child of God, he is the star in us that shines.
Yes.
Don't share God's glory. Uh-huh. Oh, you are the Lord. That is your name. You will never share your glory with anybody. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God. Child of God, don't share the glory of God. If he says he's a star, live it like that.
Yes, sir.
We are kings.
Yes, sir.
We are priests.
Yes, Jesus.
We are lords.
Yes, sir.
We are children of
the rich.
We are royal priesthood.
Yes,
we are country of people. We are holy nation. We are not stars.
We are not. Jesus,
God is
star.
He is the morning star.
He is the morning star. He is the morning star. Revelation chapter 2, verse 28.
What does it say?
And I will give him the morning star.
Amen. God Almighty said he is the star.
Hallelujah.
His real name is 2216.
Hallelujah.
I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the roots.
All the churches here.
Hallelujah.
All the green star up and down. Jesus is the one telling us the name to be calling him.
That's right. I am the root and the offspring of David.
Yeah.
And the bright and morning star.
Somebody say bright.
Yeah.
Morning star.
Morning star.
He is not the morning star. He is the bright.
And
the devil is the dark.
Yeah.
The morning star. He's the evil.
Yeah.
And the morning star. Yeah. Jesus is the bright. Yeah. Nobody else has that name. Child of God, God's name has been declared on the global altar. You cannot pick it. You can't take half. You cannot get less small. It is what he calls us that we are going to take. We are believers. We are disciples. We are Christians. We are the light of the world. We are servants. We are the salt of the earth. He has what he has called us. We are cross bearers.
Yes, sir.
We are followers of him.
Yes, sir.
We are fishers of him.
Yes, sir.
Child of God, we are not stars.
We are not.
There is no such thing a celebrity.
No.
It is a word that the devil gave to the world.
Mm.
To put people in a glass to be worshipped. Who is this Satan and worshiping? But Satan enters a guise. The Bible says he is subtle. Of all the beasts, he is subtle. He passes through things to be worshipped. He passes through people to be worshipped. Beware of indirect worship of Satan. Because the devil is not our mate. Satan is a spirit.
Yes, sir.
Satan is not physical. So he can enter a handsome billionaire.
Yes.
And corrupt young girls. And marry them up to seven wives. He can enter a very articulate preacher. And give him a tutorial. And give him billions to share. Why? Satan doesn't need dollar. He doesn't wear clothes. He doesn't need a house. He doesn't need a visa. He can give people to states. He is after souls.
Hey, Jesus.
Child of God, beware of calling somebody a star. They are deliverance today.
Amen.
Nobody's holding your staff.
Hey. Hey. That is
nobody holding your staff.
Yes,
this is a great hour.
Yes,
so I got the first John.
Yes,
chapter 4, verse 4. This is a great hour.
First John, chapter 4. Verse 4.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
Ye are of God, little children.
Yes, sir.
If you are of God, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Greater is he that is in me. The star in me is greater than they who are stars of the world. God Almighty is calling you and I. Don't claim that stardom. They will kill you in this world. Because those stars, they know themselves.
They are of the world.
They are of the world.
They are speak of the world.
We cannot compete with all these satanic stars. Who want to pervert the truth and confuse gullible people?
Yes.
The star in me cannot be captured.
At all.
Who can capture him?
Nobody can come by.
Please look for that scripture for me. In the book of Acts 17:28. And then look for the one in Colossians. And I say in him. There's something about Colossians. Let me read Acts 17:28.
Acts 17:28. For in him we live.
And move.
And have our being. Hallelujah. As certain also of your own poets have said. For we are also his offspring.
Amen. We are his offspring.
Yes.
Child of God. Who can touch you when you are in God and God in you?
Nobody.
Whenever you are saying they take my star, it's an insult to God. You are telling the Lord that he has no power. You believe in stars. God Almighty is establishing it again to us on this global altar. If he is in us, we shine. No other star. All the stars he made, they have name. Your name is not there. My name is not there. They have their purpose. God Almighty say he is the one in us.
Yes, sir.
The bright
and the morning star.
And the morning star. So you cannot have sorrow.
No.
Because the bright one is in us.
You
don't need preaching. The bright one is in us.
Yes.
To bring out our
shine.
As you are witnessing him, he's shining us. As you are serving him, he's shining us. He's renewing us like an eagle. Colossians 3:3.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 3. For ye are dead.
We are dead.
Catch
it. It's a year life.
No.
Death is a year life.
No.
It's a year life.
No.
A year life.
No.
I am dead.
No.
I am dead.
Christ is dead.
Catch it.
And his life is healed with Christ. Thank God.
My life is healed. with him.
That's right.
Nobody can touch me.
Nobody.
I don't need to have any star. So that song, that gospel singer song, Star of the Morning is not of God. Satan gave him song. We are going to begin to look into all our songs.
Yes.
There's a song about everything. The chorus was, my treasure, my pride. Are we not delivered?
Yeah,
but
thank
you, in the Jesus. Days of ignorance,
God,
the Lord wakes us up. Now that we have done, are we going to sing O Morning Star?
No.
Bright morning star.
Bright and morning star. So we shout hallelujah over there. Child of God, God is here with us.
Thank you, Lord.
The Lord Almighty is encouraging me here.
Amen.
He says, sit at my feet.
Yes.
Be a feet dweller.
Yes,
I will change your life. I will give you what people cannot get. Until you sit down there, you will know nothing. If you look around in circles, doing what people will be looking at, but God doesn't recognize. Operating without knowledge. Having zeal, but no knowledge. That leads to destruction. You'll be operating with there is a way that seems right unto it, but the end is destruction. Child of God, beware of what you see. You can be seeing something and yet your body is filled with darkness. Look at it. Proverbs 16:2. Are you buying a verse?
Yes.
Are you buying a verse?
No.
Which verse?
Colossians 3 verse.
That's what she has not Colossians 3. Yeah, in the spirit I can see. Hallelujah. Read my child. Proverbs 16, verse number 2. What a day. Feet dwellers we enjoy.
Yes,
I don't need any court or any club.
I don't go nowhere.
I don't need swimming pool. I don't need cinema. I am a feet dweller.
Yes, sir.
I can dance there. I can laugh there. I enjoy there. Yeah, I can also enjoy there.
Chapter 16, verse 2. All the ways of a man are clean in his own eyes.
He must say it is possible that everything you do is clean in your eye. Because it's filled with darkness.
Yes.
But
the Lord weigheth the
spirit. The Lord say, I'm going to weigh your spirit. And when I check what is there, I am going to judge. Beware of everything you do being right. You have something to say?
Verse 3 says, commit thy works unto the Lord.
Yes.
And thy thoughts shall be established.
What do I say with our thoughts? Our thoughts must be in line with his word.
Yes,
just confirm the ways. Proverbs 2:14. Verse 12.
Proverbs 14, verse 12.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
There is a way we see it right.
There is a way we see it right.
Unto a man.
When I was singing all the songs of old morning star, I thought it was right.
Yes.
We were enjoying it.
Yes, right, Mama.
We were feeling good people.
Yes.
God kept quiet. He said one day they will come up my feet.
Thank you, Lord.
And I will teach them.
Thank you, Lord.
To separate me.
Thank you, Lord.
To give me my place. In the place of
worship.
Wait, that's when I talk to him, huh?
But the end thereof.
Someone say end. Someone say end. All this our shakara has an end.
Yes.
This our shakara. Leave me alone. I'm in a relationship with God. It will soon end. When it ends, there is no reverse gear. There's no reverse gear. God Almighty said what is going to be told, come down from the car. When we get to the end, it is come down from the car. You can't move forward. You cannot go back. Come down from the car. Come and check your name. God Almighty said, beware of all this your chakara, all this your God, all this your boldness. Hey, the end is what?
It's
the way of death.
Right.
It's destruction. Beware of holding on to your beliefs. It is time for feet dwelling. To get heavenly belief. To become cultural with God. Enter heavenly culture. The culture of church has finished many of us. All we know is chat, 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 chat. They will carry your feet, wash in the morning, wash in the night. They are collecting glory. That is true. The real collection of glory is in the church.
Yes.
When they exchange your glory, my God, so they are, and they are getting richer. We read it in the last broadcast. They are getting richer and fatter. Their children are getting fresher, going abroad. You are suffering and dying with sickness. They cannot even pray for healing. They would rather allow your husband to die so that they will be giving you rice as a widow. They cannot pray him back to life. God Almighty said, beware of how you go and take communion in the morning. It is not holy, it is not breakfast. It is the Lord's Supper.
Hey.
All these tsunamis and winners, all these churches abroad, or Igbo people are carrying white things. Is that God's body? Is the body of Jesus, right? It is a body. It is a Nazarene body. It is a brown body. Not a white body. Holy Ghost is here. His blood is not white. His blood is red. And the wine is red. Not white.
Yes, sir.
Not black. Not Martina. Not malt. The wine is red. Not mixed with water. Mixed up and down. Very light. Blood is thick. Child of God, you have been green rubbish. Taking coming, which coming? And the morning you go there and be eating and getting hungry. It should be dinner. Now he says, eat at home. When you are now full, you can now go and take communion. You go to church with empty stomach and you be packing it and eating and taking it home. I'm calling this crackers. They share biscuit for you. Can't you see that something is wrong with your communion? They share biscuit for you. God Almighty said, come to the feet of the teacher, of Rabboni, let him teach us. Humble yourself and sit down. The Lord will deliver us.
Amen.
By his mercy.
Amen.
By our willingness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
One day, after tribulation, all these things we cost us, they shall turn to naught. They will fall down. Long set of scriptures. Ecclesiastes of the 12 verse 2. Ezekiel 32, 7. Daniel 8. 9 to 10. This should be the highest scriptures. Joel 2. 9 to 10. Joel 2, 10. Joel 3, 15. Isaiah 13, 10. Tell about tribulation. We will pass through it. Don't deceive yourself. We have our tribulation to pass through. No one should deceive you and tell you to do as you like. All this thing, that is what Porika is preaching to people. Don't worry, we will not be here. We'll be here. We go through this thing. Nobody is going to heaven with fake. Isaiah 13:10. Isaiah 13:10. Matthew 24. 29-31. Matthew 24:29-31. Mark 13:25. Mark 13:25. Revelation chapter 6, verse 13. Revelation chapter 8, 10 to 12. And finally, Revelation chapter 9, verse number 1.
Hallelujah.
The Lord said, after all the tribulation, get ready for the coming of the Lord. You will see all the stars you are worshipping. So they will give way. You will now see that we are really worshipping the devil, because only the devil falls like lightning.
Uh-huh.
they are going to fall. Begin to read some.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 2.
Yes, sir.
While the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain.
Yes. Read it again, son.
While the sun or the light or the moon or the stars.
Read from verse 1 so we will understand.
Yes. Remember that I created in the days of the youth. While the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them.
God is speaking. When you say youth, speaking to us, what children? All of us are youths.
Yes.
Why is the ancient of the youth?
Hallelujah.
God is calling us to remember Him and repent and come out of all this nonsense we are doing in this world, worshipping creature. God said, come out, because when He will come, the evil days come. When the years will draw nigh, He said, these things will hate them. He will hate sex. He will hate honor. You will hate all this, your America, all these are things that you're boasting about. You will hate your fashion. You will hate this, your fat buttocks you went to add. You will hate it. You will carry the thickest blanket and cover your breasts. That you'll be opening on social media. You will have no more pleasure in them. God said, while the sun, or the light, or the moon, or the stars, be not darkened, or the clouds, God Almighty said they are going to be darkened. All these things that are looking normal, God said, there's a tribulation coming. We will have no pleasure of the things of this world. You can stay for 3 days, you have not changed your dress. You've not even brushed your teeth. Why? Your soul is more important now. You are thinking about your soul. Now that the sun is there, now that the stars are there, let's return to the Lord. Let us repent from our evil. We are going to pray today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Next verse.
Ezekiel 32, verse 7.
Yes.
And when I shall put thee out, I will cover the heaven, and make the stars thereof dark. I will cover the sun with a cloud, and the moon shall not give her light.
So it's coming. This is coming of the Lord. This is how we are alive.
Yes, sir.
Because all the people see the revelation of 3 nights of darkness, they don't know what they are talking. The Lord said, as tribulation is rounding up, He's going to come. We will see it. Once the people of God are living here, once light is going, you begin to see this star. Everything in place will change automatically. Everything will change. No generator plant, nothing will be able to bring light. They'll be announcing, America will be announcing, we don't know what has taken the light. Child of God, American light went off, was it last year or so? During COVID, their light went off and everybody was going into frenzy. People were crying, people were jumping up and down, lining up in the streets of Texas to go and fetch water inside your mono pump. God Almighty said, you're not even saying anything. That one is rehearsal. That one is rehearsal. We in Nigeria, Africa, we are used to light going off. You will not be sure you will see darkness. It will burn down the house. God Almighty said, He is going to darken everywhere. He will tell the world that He is the light of the world. He's going to take back His light. Because many of us don't even appreciate God. It's a little thanksgiving. You don't ever thank God for day and night. There's a separation that God does. God will deliver us of ingratitude. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Daniel chapter 8.
Yes.
9 to 10.
Yes, sir.
And out of one of them came forth a little thorn, which waxed exceeding great, toward the south and toward the east, and toward the pleasant land. Verse 10.
Yes.
And it waxed great, even to the host of heaven. And it cast down some of the hosts and of the stars to the ground, and stamped upon them.
These things are going to come down.
Yes, sir.
They are dropping. Do you know the size of a star? You know, the further things are, the smaller they look.
Yes.
If one by the last one star to come near us, we are gone. It can cover the whole of Nigeria. That is what natural education teaches us. Star, one star. And God said, go and count if you can count. He says some of them, he didn't say all. Some we drop. And cover nations. We will see God. But that one will be at his back laughing. We are not going to stay here and be suffering that thing.
No.
We shall be gone. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Joel chapter 2, verse 10.
Yes, sir.
The earth shall quake before the heavens shall tremble. The sun and the moon shall be dark. And the stars shall withdraw their shine.
Yes, sir. God beware of being left behind. Beware of missing the rapture. If you don't fear anything in this world, child of God, forget about cancer. All those are nothing. God is saying, fear this day when you will be here and seeing this things. Because people of God will not be here.
Hey.
They cannot focus on that. We would have left. God will begin to withdraw his things. He will begin to scatter everywhere. Child of God, don't mind the people that are playing around this world. There is a day coming. There is a day when God will be in charge. There is a day when everybody will know that there is a God.
Ah.
God will not about the affairs of
yes,
man.
Jesus.
Who is not a slow God? Who is not a slack God? Who knows how to punish the children of men and disobedience? Joel chapter 3, verse 15.
Joel chapter 3, and in verse 15.
Yes, sir.
The sun and the moon shall be darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shine.
Yes, sir. Child of God, this thing is going to happen as the tribulation is rounding up. I told you, whether you like it or not, we are going to experience part of tribulation. We're not going to escape it. Nobody should deceive you without preaching. We will be part of it. It has even started.
Yes.
But it will be stronger.
Yes.
It will be stronger. I cannot deceive you. We cannot pray against things. There are some things we cannot pray against. One of it is this. Things will get worse and worse.
Yes.
Beware of what I tell you about blessing. Everybody preaching. Any preacher is preaching blessing, blessing. Now, it's not of God. It's a fake preacher.
Yes.
They don't know Jesus. Things are not going to get better. Yeah. It's like one new Nigeria. Okay. We have free education. Go and save money.
Yeah.
Save even pay school fees. Yeah, come up. Go
and
get ready. Nothing like butter. I don't see that I'm 11 teeth. Nothing like that. God said, get ready. Because his children cannot be comfortable in this world. I am homesick. All manner of wickedness everywhere. Kidnapping everywhere. These two children are beginning to drink alcohol. 21-year-old is trampling and killing people. And he said that with their Jesus should not come. From the land of the focus on there. God Almighty is going to come.
Amen.
And the stars are going to drop.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We don't.
Isaiah 13, lesson from verse 9.
Okay.
Behold, the day of the Lord cometh.
Uh-huh.
Cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger.
What's that cruel?
Cruel.
Child of God is not gentle Jesus. That is not about Jesus. That time of Christmas, it has passed. He is coming cruel. What's that cruel?
Cruel.
He is coming with a face that you cannot be. He's coming with vengeance. He's coming with anger. He's coming with all manner of wrath. All the anger you have been reserving, he's coming with it. Upon the children of disobedience. Beware of peace. When there's no peace, God Almighty is gathering his pack of vengeance. He's coming the day of the Lord.
That's right.
To
lay the land desolate.
God said, I was going to scatter everywhere.
And he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of his.
Somebody say sinner.
Sinners.
Who is deceiving people?
Yeah.
God says sinners.
Yes.
There are many.
Yes.
All the children.
Hey, child of God.
Yes,
we are fighting this battle of sin. This flesh must die every day. God Almighty said, I am coming for sinners. He didn't say, he didn't say unbelievers. So if you're a Christian and you're committing sin, you're a sinner. God Almighty said, don't let anybody deceive you.
Yes.
Jesus has already died for our sin.
Uh-huh.
So if you commit sin, it is your body that is committing sin. Your flesh is committing sin. So God is going to punish your flesh. It's your flesh, not you. If God punishes your flesh with cancer, you're not gone.
Uh-huh.
Beware of evil creatures.
Yes.
And go. Who are telling you that you can live in sin and still make heaven? God is going to expose all of them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. For the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light.
Uh-huh.
And the sun shall be darkened.
Yes, sir.
In his going forth.
Uh-huh.
And the moon shall not cause her light to shine.
God, when he says it's going to be a terrible day. Cross darkness. I cannot be here.
I will not be here.
You will not be here.
No.
We will be ready for him. In the name of Jesus Christ. Matthew 24. Matthew 24. Any child of God, you joke with Matthew 24, you have lost it in this world. Yeah. That is our chapter.
Yes,
29 to 31.
Matthew 24, 29 to 31.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened.
Somebody say immediately.
Immediately.
After the tribulation.
After the tribulation.
Of those days.
What is going to happen?
Shall the sun be darkened.
Uh-huh.
And the moon shall not give her light.
Uh-huh.
And the stars shall fall from heaven.
Yes.
And the powers of the heaven shall be shaken.
Uh-huh.
And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven.
Uh-huh.
And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn.
Uh-huh.
And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the
clouds. Yes.
Verse 31. And he shall send his angels with the great sound of the trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other.
Child of God, this is going to happen. This is the will of God. Tribulation?
Yes.
It's going to happen. Yeah. Yes. We're going to go through it. It has already started.
Yes.
That is why God is going to strengthen us.
Amen.
I want to be here. I want to enjoy with God.
Yes, Lord.
I want God to demonstrate His power through me.
Amen.
I don't want to die before time. Child of God, there's a way you'll be so afraid. God will take you before time.
Yes.
That is Isaiah 57. He will take you before time because you will backslide. If you don't get strong now, child of God, God can take you home before time. Be strong. Let the Lord see that you can stay, that you can follow Him and still shine. For without darkness, light is useless.
Yes,
it is in the midst of darkness that we shine. I don't care what they are doing. God Almighty said, if we can stay with Him, we will be distinguished. We will be separated. People are going to run when they see a little light coming from a particular place. They want to hear the word of God. They will run. I said, teach me this word. I want to hear this word. God Almighty, at that time, Jerry Eze cannot function.
At all
the prophets will be lost. What people want to hear is how to escape this judgment. The truth of holiness. Holiness message is the deliverer of the end time. And God is going to strengthen us. God will strengthen us.
Amen.
Internet, we are here.
Yes, sir.
We are going to do as God will strengthen us.
Amen.
We are going to do outreaches.
Amen.
We are going to do crusades.
Amen.
God Almighty will have a harvest of souls.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What's the next verse of scripture?
Mark chapter 13, verse 25.
Mark 13, 25.
And the stars of heaven shall fall.
Uh-huh.
And the powers that are in heaven shall be shaken.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God Almighty said, look at what is going to happen. Are you not afraid? Thunder outside, people are shaking.
Yes.
Lightning, people are praying the blood of Jesus. Lightning supposed to sound because maybe God is shaking somewhere.
Yes.
Maybe God just moved small table to arrange in my room. Just set up arrange my room. And somebody said, my enemies have come. Which enemy?
Which enemy?
God Almighty said his voice is thunder. His voice is lightning. God Almighty said he can see when I'm gathering meeting. Don't want to touch one of his children like me. And he will do and the meeting will scatter. They are cannot be pulled off. Their network will scatter. They will receive phone calls. Hello. Meeting will close down. God Almighty said thunder is his voice. He's going to shout that day. The wickedness of men. Don't mind his quietness. Daddy God is God, patient girl.
Hallelujah.
Long suffering.
Yes, sir.
But we don't know when the rope is going to end.
Hey.
We don't dare God. God said it's going to be dark.
Hey.
Revelation chapter 6, verse 13.
And the stars of heaven fell onto the earth. Even as
as a victory cancer on timely feet. Uh-huh. When she is shaking of a biting
victory cancer his lips. Untimely lips. That means God Almighty is telling you that time that you think he is going to come, that far time, he can change his mind.
Yeah.
Read it again, sir. This is untimely there. Read it again.
Revelation chapter 6, verse 13.
What does it say?
And the stars of heaven fell onto the earth.
Uh-huh.
Even as a victory casted her untimely feet.
Son of God, don't God Almighty say, who are you to tell me when I'm going to come? I have time to come, Akotaria. You cannot budget for 10 years' time. You cannot plan for 10 years' time. You don't know when I'm going to come. I said, the way I'm going to come, it will be like a fig that will shut off his untimely lips. Don't joke with God. God can decide to do. That's why he put the scripture for himself. He said, I do as I please.
Yes.
I'm the sovereign God. I am the Almighty. So you cannot hold him to anything. God Almighty said, I'm coming. All these stars are going to drop. They will become nothing. You will see that God is the one that created. He knows how to cast down in the
Mediterranean.
Read the last other verse. 8 to 10. Chapter 8.
10 to 12.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as a tree and a lamp.
Yes.
And it fell upon the third part of the rivers, and upon the fountains of waters. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became Wormwood. And many men died of the waters, because they were made bitter. Verse 12.
Yes.
And the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten.
And the third part of the moon, and the third part of the stars,
so as the third part of
them
was darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it,
and the night
likewise.
Gentlemen, these are dangerous times. We cannot be here. How can we be here? We would have left.
Amen.
I want to encourage all of you, please let us all go the same time. When the doctor will come. But in case you miss it, don't take the back. Just in case you miss it, endure. Because people are not going to believe. Some people don't believe that there will be rapture. So you wouldn't be able to live this world forever. That's why you are investing all your money to build a skyscraper. You want to answer a landowner, a house owner. You want to have all things of this world. This is the way you plan. Your planning has no program of rapture. So it's by adventure. You miss the rapture on the day you are fighting over land in the court. Don't take the mark of the beasts. Endure the days of the Antichrist. And God Almighty will have mercy. But I bet you pay with your life. This message will may be removed from the internet. So God Almighty will help us to have reservation of messages.
Amen.
But adventure people miss the rapture. God Almighty will tell them, remember that message. Don't take the mark so that you'll not be eternally condemned. Because God says some people will still make it, but they will pay with their lives. Do not allow us to be in that category.
Amen.
I fear for my life, that's why my voice is down. I fear for my own soul. Child of God, once this thing happens, Bible says it is immediately. As soon as it is over, these things begin to happen. You don't know that time. So you cannot take risk. So every day of our lives, we must be conscious that there is a day of the Lord coming. The day of his anger. The day of his wrath. He's passing us through purging. He's cleansing us to prepare us so that we will not be caught on our ways. The Lord will deliver us and the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the last verse.
9 verse 1. And the fifth angel sounded.
Yes.
And I saw a star fall from heaven unto the earth.
Yes.
and to him was given the key of the bottomless pit.
Child of God, God is going to be sending angels on errands. They'll be coming to do work. Go and open bottomless pits. Put the devil there. Go and open the gates there. Do this. God Almighty said, we have established that these angels are also stars. So the Lord God Almighty will be sending them a message. He is calling us to be humble and learn of him. Nobody should ever open mouth again to say, somebody took my star. I am a star. Don't call any human being a star. Be proud of something. He said, but Esther means star. Do you know that Esther represents Jesus Christ?
Jesus
is a type. She's a type. It's a metal tree. Her name is a metal tree. That name is not because her name is Hadassah. Hadassah is her name. But God Almighty had to use that name, Esther, star, to symbolize her, that she is coming to clean up the unclean. That is you and I. Jesus came for sinners, of which I am chief. We are going to cry to God today, prayer. We are going to repent of attempting to share the glory of God by calling ourselves a star, by calling a human being a star. I refuse to be a star. Jesus is a star. He's the bright and the morning star. Lift your voice, begin to worship him. Begin to bless the name of the Lord. Worship the bright and the morning star. Oh, Rakakalataya. Worship him, Rakakalataya. Oh, Rakakalataya. Oh, Jesus. Name of all. Oh, beautiful Savior.
Oh,
Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have worshipped. Child of God, let that be your attitude on the day of Jesus. To declare that it is God. Because you are going to repent today. But God of Christ, oh God, I say, Father, show me mercy. Lord, which I did not regard you as God. When I declare and say, God is man. I treated you the way I treat man. I treated you like a human being. I did not regard your word. I did not regard your commandments. I am sorry, Lord, when I took your word for granted, O God. I am sorry, Lord. Have mercy on me, O God. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Child of God, the Bible says that God is not slack. As men count slackness, but is long suffering towards us. Not willing that we should perish, child of God. The fact that sin looks like it is prevailing does not mean that God is slack. Have you not seen it all through scripture? The day of the Lord is coming. That day when everything will fall, when everything will come to the ground, when everything will worship him. For Joseph was a type of Jesus, and he showed it to us in the book of Genesis. He gave him a dream, and the devil shook at him. That day is coming. He's talking about the day of the Lord, when everything in creation will bow. Child of God, are you going to heed this warning today? That day is coming. The Lord is teaching us today that we should humble ourselves. Enough of pride. We're going to cry to God today. I say, Father, I repent of my pride. His glory with anyone. But we have celebrated men. When God is saying that celebration belongs to him, child of God, we are going to repent. When we kept on saying, I celebrate you. Child of God, we are worshiping man. One more time. Daddy, thank you for your mercy. Because man would have been struck dead. For the minute the people shouted and said that Aaron spoke like a god, the Bible said he was struck. And eating up. We are going to cry to God today. I said, Father, forgive me. When I celebrated man, when I tapped with my finger, when I spoke it with my mouth, oh God, Lord, I am sorry. I am sorry, Lord. When I declare somebody as a special, as time, a celebration of man, I celebrated man. I met them people who didn't celebrate me, oh God. Just because you did a little wonder in my life, I am so celebrating for you. Because of me, I have become an angel of God. I am sorry, Lord. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Child of God, we are going to repent from that prayer of everyone holding my star. You and I do not have any star. As as our mother was ministering, she said, some people will prophesy and say, that's a child with a star. The Lord has said to us here, no child has a star.
Jesus.
All children are special gifts from the Lord.
Yes, sir.
They are his heritage.
Yes.
Do you know what it means for somebody to give you heritage? Our deliverance is here today. Because you are going to cry to God and say, Father, forgive me. When I declare myself as a star, when I declare a man as a star, I began to compete with you. We are Masukeria. Don't be cause of a gift. Just because of something you did in my life, I began to answer, star. Lord, I am sorry. Stars, we gave ourselves a seat.
Yes.
We began to exalt ourselves. We began to feel important. But today, God said to us that today's broadcast is for feet dwellers.
Yes.
Where you are going to leave your seat and sit at the foot.
Yes.
The foot place is on the floor. We have no seats. Jesus is the only one to sit on the seat of Calabos. For he is the only star of Calabos. You are going to declare today, I said, Father, I come down from my exalted seat. I sit at your feet. I come to Lord. I come to Lord. I come to Lord. From my exalted seat. I sit at your feet, O God. A fearful day. A day that nobody knows about. The Bible says no day nor night. Likewise, how prepared are you for that day? Yeah. How prepared are you for that day that nobody knows about? When the face of Jesus will change. How prepared are you? It is time for us to get ready. It is time for us to get ready. Child of God, if you fear not, then fear that thing. The Bible says it is going to come like a thief in the night. Are you not seeing what is happening in our time? That day has come for several people. Without their planning, they planned few days on their birthday.
Yes.
And God said, I will not allow you to celebrate that birthday.
Yes.
Are you not hearing of untimely things? Who has a clock? Yes. Hey! How prepared are you? You're going to cry out to God. I said, Father, whatever we make that day,
don't
take me unawares. That is why the Lord is asking us to repeat this prayer. I don't know how much strength you have. If ordinary becomes a palliative, you broke into a warehouse and you took things that does not belong to you. How much can you stay when you will not be permitted to buy nor sell? If only because of the promise of man, you have gone to take the job and now you are crying, what is our state? Are you not afraid? You are going to cry to God. I don't know what is that thing. Is it work? Is it money? Is it family? Is it a relationship? What is that thing that is capable of making you to say, I will pay with my blood? How easy it is, Kalababa. If at this time you cannot withstand, at that time, who told you your car? Cry out to God and say, Father, whatever I need to do, whatever it shall cost me, to go, oh God, at rapture. Father, do it in my life. Do it in my family. Do it in the life of my loved ones. I don't want to miss the rapture. I don't want to miss the rapture. I don't want to miss the rapture.
Yes,
sir. Yes, we are praying.
Amen. Oh, down at your feet, oh Lord, is the most high place. In your presence, Lord, I seek your face. I seek to be humble, to deliver me from pride. Deliver me from the pride of life. Deliver me, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we are praying. It is one thing to desire to learn. It is another thing to know where you are going to learn. God Almighty said, if you want to learn, you cannot go to prophetic service.
Yes, sir.
You cannot go to miracle service. The place of learning is the place of teaching.
Yes, sir.
Where the word of God will be broken. Rightly dividing the word of truth.
Yes,
you are going to cry and say, Father, direct me to your classroom.
Amen.
You are going to renounce all the things we have done with stars. All those we opened our palm to. All those we sent images of ourselves. All those that we told to speak, to look about our life and speak. They are called stargazers. We are going to separate from them. It is called self-deliverance. We are going to come out of anything that we have entered into. Horoscope. Every prophet that did any work, they said, they're doing work for us.
Assignment.
Through coconut, through coke, Fanta, all those things. We are going to separate from them. All these, I am Aries, I am Scorpio. You are going to deny them to me. All these Shambhala response that you wear, all those beads, all those chaplets, we are going to separate from them. Child of God, you are going to lift your voice and cry to God.
Yes, Lord.
Anybody that you have taken as a star and a celebrity, and you put their picture in your house, it can be a preacher.
Yes, yes.
And you said, you are connected to their grace. You are connected to their star. You are connected to them. You are going to divorce today. Because Jesus cannot live in you. And you are connected to the star of a human being. He is a star. He is the bright and the morning star. He cannot stay with the temple of the same temple with idols. Father. Every connection I have with any
Satan. With stars.
With prophets.
With prophets.
Palm readers.
Palm readers.
Whatever I have given to them.
Whatever I have given to them.
To see something about me.
To see something about me.
And it begins to work in my life.
And it is beginning to work.
Every Facebook game.
Every Facebook game.
God has spoken about me.
God has spoken about
and
me.
And I believed it.
And I believed
so
it. I separate from them. All the Facebook games, all the OMG,
Jesus Christ, mighty name we are praying. When you put off, you put on. You are going to begin to say, Jesus, you are the bright and the morning star.
You are the bright and the morning star.
Take your place in my heart.
Take your place in my children.
Be our star. Because the Lord is going to give us revelation.
Amen.
Some of you are going to dream, and the Lord will tell you some of the connections you entered into. The Lord is going to open your eyes to some blood oath you entered without knowing. The Lord is going to open your eyes to some communion you ate, some food you ate. The Lord will open our eyes. This season of total surrender to the Lord, God Almighty will deliver us.
Amen.
With revelation.
Amen.
With secrets.
Amen.
The Lord will reveal secrets. The Lord will reveal secrets.
Amen.
For self-deliverance.
Amen.
Because many of you are going to go into midnight prayers.
Amen.
Ah, thank you, Jesus. I begin to retrieve things from the computer of the devil.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You're going to take authority over your life that you have surrendered to the devil. He will take authority. He will take it back.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord strengthen us.
Amen.
The Lord preserve you.
Amen.
The Lord keep you.
Amen.
In the hollow of his hand.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But dear, our body, the marks of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We dump your body of stars. We renounce it. We are not stars. We are the sons of the Most High God.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And God Almighty will preserve us.
Amen.
Keep on pressing on.
Amen.
Go back and listen to this message again.
Yes, Lord.
And let the Lord God Almighty strengthen you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
If Jesus tells you, meet again on Sunday.
Amen.
By 2 p.m.
Amen.
To get further announcements.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Heaven is our home.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
Love you plenty, plenty.
Love you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. You're going to lift up a voice and cry and say, Father.
Father.
When the tribulation shall be over.
When the tribulation shall be over.
And these things will happen.
And these things will happen.
Let me and my family not be found in this world.
Let me and my family.
Oh, I'm thinking when my Lord shall come.
I'm not going to be able to do that.